Today, I wish to say that last day we talked about prokaryotic cell, and in prokaryotic cell, I taught you the major concept, that is the difference between gram positive and gram negative. You can see here there are various differences between gram positive and gram negative bacteria mentioned here. सबसे पहली बात ये दैट इन केस ऑफ ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया आफ्टर वॉशिंग विद एब्सोल्यूट अल्कोहल इट विल रिटेन इट्स पर्पल कलर. इन केस ऑफ ग्राम नेगेटिव इट विल नॉट. इन केस ऑफ ग्राम पॉजिटिव वॉल इज सिंगल लेयर्ड एंड इन केस ऑफ ग्राम नेगेटिव टू लेयर्स. हियर द थिकनेस ऑफ वॉल इज मोर हियर लेस. Lipid content in gram positive is very low, whereas in case of gram negative it is quite high. On the contrary, the mucopeptide, that is murine or peptidoglycan, is very high in gram positive, which is comparatively very low. Ticoic acid, which is a characteristic acid, it is present only in case of gram positive cell wall. It is not present in case of gram negative bacteria. And purine proteins, these are purine proteins are basically channel proteins. They are absent in gram positive, whereas they are present in gram negative. Here are some examples of gram positive and gram negative bacteria. Yes, Vicky.
Ma'am, can you repeat?
Vicky, I cannot hear you, beta.
Ma'am, can you repeat?
Repeat the whole thing. Any specific point you want to mention, Vicky, or the whole thing? Vicky, I cannot hear you, beta. Can anyone hear him? Ayushi? Vicky, jo bol raha hai, sun pa rahe ho, beta? I cannot hear any one of you. Let me check. So prokaryotic last day. So I am not talking about them here clearly. I want to talk about something which is very important, and majorly students are having doubt in them. This is the difference between pili and fimbriae. Okay, so pili is generally occur only in gram negative bacteria, whereas fimbriae is present in case of both gram positive and gram negative bacteria. Pili are generally longer and broader because they are meant for the transfer of DNA from one bacteria to another. So they are longer and broader. And the fimbriae are shorter and narrower. It is specialized for attachment, whereas pili is responsible for conjugation. Conjugation is a procedure. I am going to definitely teach you this while I was talking. I will talk about Monera. And they are tubular, means tube-like structure. Whereas fimbriae are more like bristle. Jaise brush mein hota hai na, jaise bristle jaisa. Structure होता है. So I guess the difference between fimbriae and pili is clear to everyone of you. Because yesterday it seems a few confusion was there. Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So as I told you, in case of ribosome of prokaryotes, you yourself mentioned it is of 70S. So this 70S can be further subdivided into two subunits. These are 30S and 50S. 30S is the smaller subunit, whereas 50S is the larger subunit. And inclusion bodies are storage food material. It depends on the organism to organism. For example, cyanobacteria, which is also known as blue-green algae, because as it had cell wall and it is green in color, that's why many people are confused that it must be a plant and it is an algae. That's why it's been, it was renamed as blue-green algae. But baad mein jab, after discovery of improved microscope, they observed that cyanobacteria have more similarity with the monerans because it is basically prokaryotic in nature. That's why they are included in monerans. So these cyanobacteria has cyanophycin granules. They may have glycogen granules. Small vacuoles or sulfur granules are also common. Okay. So, in cyanobacteria or purple green photosynthetic bacteria, gas vacuoles are prominent. And they are responsible for storage of the gases. Is up to this part any more doubts, anyone regarding prokaryotes? If not, then today we will move towards the eukaryotic cell. Fine. Any doubts? Anyone better?
No, ma'am. No doubt.
No, ma'am.
Vicky, you must have joined with two devices. Echoing is there.
Yes, ma'am.
Hai na, ek kaam karo. You keep one at mute. That's well. No problem. So, we will talk today about the eukaryotic cell. I am just opening my note because we are brushing up these things very fast so that we can move ahead for the next chapter. In case of prokaryotic cell, the main cellular part can be subdivided into specific portions. They may have cell wall or cell membrane or glycocalyx as a covering. Glycocalyx is a structure which is generally observed in case of animal cells because it acts as a extra protection in their case. Whereas in case of plant cell, the cell wall is having too much deposition of lignin and suberin and it is very hard and it is giving it excellent protection. Apart from that, cell membrane is also there. So these three are the covering of the cell. Whatever lies inside cell membrane is called protoplasm. Everything that lies inside cell membrane is called protoplasm. So protoplasm is this one and protoplast includes cell membrane as well as protoplasm. Protoplasm can be further subdivided into jelly-like substance called cytoplasm as well as nucleus. Cytoplasm is having various constituents. Let us have a look at what are the constituents possible in case of cytoplasm. They have ergastic substances. What are ergastic substances? Who is going to tell me what are ergastic substances? Anyone? Okay, no problem. I will tell. See, ergastic substances are substances which doesn't have life. Yes, Vicky, follow. Vicky, you want to ask something, beta?
Ma'am, can you please repeat the meaning of ergastic?
Lifeless storage food or lifeless substances or granules present in the cell are called ergastic substances. For example, this may include the reserve food material. For example, in our case, if any cell is storing glycogen or fatty substances, if plant stem cells are storing starch, all these are considered as reserve food material. So whenever we are taking some extra food, they are stored in the form of reserve food material. Yes, Vicky, bolo.
Ma'am, ergastic food are non-living substances.
Yes, they are simply the organic and inorganic particles present in the cytosol. There may be some secretory products also. Sometimes lysosome or the Golgi secrete some enzyme which are present in the cell. That can be also considered as ergastic substance. For example, in our cell, if urea is present or carbon dioxide is present as a gas, these are excretory products. They can be considered as ergastic substances. Next are mineral crystals. Have you ever noticed one thing? Agar aap ghaas ko aise khicho to aapki haath mein cut ho jati hai. The blades, the leaves of grass are quite tough. I'm not talking about the small ones, the big ones. Ya fir bamboo ki bhi leaf leke aap agar aise khichoge na, there are chances that your hands can get injured. Why? Because those leaves are having silica present in them. Chalo aur ek example dete hu. Aapko pata hai ek wo पात्रा बनाते गुजराती लोग, पात्रा तो पता है ना सबको.
यस मैम.
पात्रा में पत्ता यूज होता है बड़े से प्लांट का, उसको क्या बोलते हो आप लोग? ऐसा लीफ होता है उसका. देखो अभी अगर आप लोग बोलोगे कि आपको पता नहीं, देन आई एम शॉक. It's like ऐसे पत्ते होते हैं उसके. Yes यशवी.
मैम आपने क्या बोला question?
मैंने पूछा कि पात्रा होता है ना खाने वाला, tasty.
Yes मैम.
वो एक specific type के पान से बनाते हैं, मतलब ऐसे पत्ते से बनाते हैं. वो plant को क्या बोलते हो आप in Gujarati? In English it is known as colocasia.
अडवील का पान.
हाँ
अडवील का पान.
हाँ तो उसकी जो रूट होती है ना, दैट इज हैविंग स्ट्रक्चर लाइक दिस, और उसको हम सुरन बोलते हैं, वो भी खाते हैं. पता है सुरन खाने से कभी कभी गले में इचिंग होती है, दैट इज ड्यू टू डिपोजिशन ऑफ क्रिस्टल्स. उसमें कैल्शियम ऑक्सालेट का क्रिस्टल रहता है विच इज कॉजिंग इचिंग टू द थ्रोट. तो ऐसे कई केसेस में मिनरल्स के क्रिस्टल्स आर प्रेजेंट इन द सेल, दोस क्रिस्टल्स कैन आल्सो बी कंसीडर्ड एज एर्गास्टिक सब्सटेंसेस. सो ऑल दीज रिजर्व फूड मटेरियल, सीक्रेटरी प्रोडक्ट, एक्सक्रीटरी प्रोडक्ट, मिनरल क्रिस्टल, ऑल ऑफ देम कैन बी कंसीडर्ड एज द एर्गास्टिक सब्सटेंसेस. क्लियर टू एवरीवन?
यस मैम.
Next is cytoskeleton. It is very important, especially in case of animal cell, because the animal cell is having cell membrane, which is not at all a rigid structure. तो जब तुम यहाँ ऐसे गाल को दबा रहे हो, तुम्हारे cells जो होते हैं वो पिचक नहीं जाते हैं ना, they don't get depressed, ऐसे oppressed नहीं हो जाते. How they maintain their shape? Their shapes are maintained due to the skeleton-like structures present in their cytoplasm, which is made up of small tube-like structures called microtubule and microfilament. Both microtubule and microfilament is made up of protein, and altogether they form a skeleton-like structure called cytoskeleton. Okay, I'm just giving you a brief idea over here. Obviously, we will talk about them in detail. Cytoskeleton is clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So yes. Now next part is are the membrane bound organelles. So what are cell organelles? Cell organelles are living entity of the cell, and they have division of labor and they do specific function of the cell. Some of the cell organelles are present in all types of cell. That is, even if it is plant cell, it is present. Even if it is animal cell, it is present. But in case of some specific cell organelle, they are restricted to specific type. For example, the centrosome is specifically present in animal cell. Okay. Then plastid is present in case of plant cell. Golgi complex generally is not present in plants, but in case of some lower plants, it is present. We call them pictiosome. So I hope you studied about all of them. We will talk about one of them, each one of them individually. The most important part of cell, which is the control unit or the brain of cell, is nucleus. So nucleus is made up of nuclear membrane, which is the covering of nucleus, which makes the prokaryotic cell different from eukaryotic. And then the nucleoplasm, chromatin, and nucleolus. So I will give you 2 minutes. All of you look into this chart and let me know if you have any doubt in regarding any part.
No, ma'am, no doubt.
Ma'am?
Yes, beta?
Ma'am, in cytoskeleton, microtubules, intermediate filaments, and then microfilaments will not come?
Yes, they will come. I am just giving you a brief idea about them. These are the 2 major important parts. Obviously, we will discuss about each one of them collectively and individually. We will do that, no worries.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so I am moving ahead. Now we will talk about the like each one of the part one by one. Okay, so this is the structure of the cell. And generally, it is having the different parts mentioned with their name and their function. These are the difference between plant cells and animal cells. I want you people to understand this is something where every part of cell is mentioned and if it is absent or present, that is mentioned. And if it is having any variation, that is mentioned. Kindly go through this table and let me know if you have any doubt. I don't think there will be any doubt. Actually, you people studied it once. That's why I'm kind of skipping it.
मैम
यस बेटा
मैम प्लांट में 70s राइबोसोम प्रेजेंट होते हैं 80s
वेयर इट इज मेंशन
नो मैम आई एम आस्किंग
80s ओनली ऑल यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स आर हैविंग 80s लाइक राइबोसोम
ओके मैम
मैम
यस बेटा
मैम प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन तो दोनों में नहीं है ना एनिमल सेल एंड प्लांट सेल में
दोनों में प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन नहीं है दोनों में प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन होता है इट्स नॉट मेंशनड बिकॉज़ इट्स नॉट डिफरेंस इन केस ऑफ बोथ प्लांट एज वेल एज एनिमल प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन इज देयर दैट्स व्हाई इट्स नेम इज नॉट मेंशनड हियर It's mentioned here like this, that plasma membrane, only cell membrane is there in case of animal cell. In case of plant, it is having cell wall as well as cell membrane. Cell wall is outer part and cell membrane is the inner part.
Okay, ma'am.
Should we move ahead, class?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
No one is having any doubt, na?
No, ma'am, no doubt.
Okay. No, ma'am, no doubt.
So, we will now look into specific cell organelles. This is the structure of eukaryotic cell, which belongs to animal kingdom. And this one is plant cell. So structures, obviously you need to practice because diagrams, it is easy to remember and diagrams can be asked in written examinations. So we will start today our discussion with the concept of cell wall. It was the person who discovered cell wall was Robert Hooke, and he was working on his microscope. And he was kind of observed the structure which is actually like a cell. That's why it is known, he only named itself as a cell. Cell means the small chamber. Okay. So in absent, it is absent in animal cell, but it is present in case of plants as well as in case of fungi. Cell wall is a very important structure because it gives shape to the cell. Not only gives shape to the cell, it actually protects plant cells from the external activities. Have you ever wondered that why plant cells are having cell wall and animal cells generally do not have? Can you tell me why? Why plants require this extra set of protection? Present in
May?
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, plant cell have cell wall because these cell wall are made up of cellulose and provide protection to the plant cell, and animal cell are made up of phospholipids by layer and proteins.
So that too I know, but why? Why plant cells require this special protection? What is so special and what is the most important difference between plant cell and animal? Anyone? Think about it and let me know. Anyone want to guess? Don't you think plants are non-motile? They require this extra set of protection. Whereas animals can move, they can protect themselves, they can flee from the Yes, Yashvi.
Ma'am, animal cells are somewhat flexible, but plants are not flexible that much from inside of the cell.
Yes, yes, so obviously.
They need these extra structure.
So that is true, but why they require? My question was, see, you people need to pinpointly understand the questions. What I asked you is, yes, Vicky, bolo.
Ma'am, plants need rigid structure so they can grow up and out.
Not only grow up, they require this special protective structure, beta. Agar ye unke paas nahi hoga, then it will be very difficult for them to manage. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
okay. Yes, ma'am.
So, now we will move ahead. This is about the general introduction of cell wall. Now, cell wall is a rigid structure and it is non-living. Although, let me tell you, current research sometimes says that it also is living, but most of its proof is towards its non-living nature. And it can have various thickness. Let me tell you one interesting fact, that in a same plant cell, the thickness of cell wall varies. When plant cells are young and they are just had division, the cell wall thickness is quite low. It is very small. Whereas when they are having a very, like they grow old, sometimes even they die, the cell wall remains there, and the due to deposition they have very thick nature. Okay, so it is like inseparable part of plant cell. They protect plant cells from mechanical damage. They protect plant cells from various type of infection. It is commonly observed that jaise ki hamare skin mein kahin pe cut ho jaye, to that area we always protect with antiseptic and all. Why? Because cut is the place through which microbes can go inside our body. Okay. Similarly, plant cell is wall is a place which is protecting plants from the external infections. Okay. So that is how it can be, if it is removed or if it is having deep injury, then plants are more susceptible towards the infection. Okay. Now, what is the chemical composition of plant cells? Major important part of plant cell wall is the cellulose. But it's not only one. Other than cellulose, there can be galactans, mannans, and apart from this, calcium carbonate can be there. Let me tell you, sometimes pectin can have like a relationship, or it can have a mixed compound which is called calcium or magnesium pectate. So cellulose is the major part. It makes the backbone of the cell wall, but other substances are also there, like hemicellulose, lignin, suberin. These get deposited on the cell wall, and finally the cell wall is getting its shape. Okay, so majorly cell wall can be subdivided into three parts. These are middle lamella, primary and secondary cell wall. Let me tell you, during the time of cell division, I will remind you once again while I will teach you cell division. During the time of cell division, the first layer that is formed is middle lamella. So, if I try and draw two cells, adjacent cells, do you think middle lamella will present outside or inside? Class students, if I
draw inside.
Inside. No. Middle lamella is actually the cementing material which is connecting the two cells. इनसाइड मिडल लैमिना देयर विल बी प्रोडक्शन ऑफ प्राइमरी सेल वॉल एंड इनसाइड प्राइमरी सेल वॉल देयर विल बी प्रोडक्शन ऑफ सेकेंडरी सेल वॉल. लेट मी टेल यू दिस इज द कंसेप्ट. अंडरस्टूड एवरीवन?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, at the time of cell division, it is the first thing, the thing which is synthesized first is the middle lamella, and after that there will be production of primary cell wall. So then, why we divide it as primary and secondary? Because, beta, middle lamella is a compulsory thing. I told you, it is the first produced part of cell wall. It is made up of calcium and magnesium pectate. Yes, Ruthu, you want to ask something, beta?
Ma'am.
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, the question you asked about primary cell wall and secondary cell wall, the answer to that is, at the time of primary cell wall, the cell is in immature state, and secondary cell wall only forms when cell is in mature state.
Yes, very good. So it is actually depends on the maturity. Young cells have only up to primary cell wall, and secondary cell walls are produced as they mature. So how cell walls are produced? Let me tell you, cell walls are the part which are having microfibers of cellulose. So, the way many thin filament-like structures of cellulose microfibers are composed to form the bundle of fibers, and then these bundle of cells are fibers are composing the whole cell wall. Same occur here in case of in case of the cellulose. So what I can want to say basically is thin filaments are there. So cellulose fibers are filament like structures. Many of such filaments form a bundle of filaments. And many of such bundle of filaments are actually forming the structure of the cell wall. And whatever other materials are there, they are simply getting deposited into this framework of cellulose. The main framework is made up of cellulose fibers. Is it clear to all?
Yes, ma'am.
So, cell wall is having following functions. You can look into them. Wait for a moment. These are the several functions performed by cell wall. We talked about them. Cell wall is a very good way of interaction between two cells. In a multicellular organism, all cells need to be connected with each other. That means they need to have some connection or communication between them, because they don't work as a single cell. They work as a, what I can say, they work specifically as a network of cell. And the function of multicellular organism is not function of a single cell. It is function of effect of all cells. That we studied. That's why cell is called structural and functional unit. So, as cell wall is very rigid, how do you think the two adjacent plant cells are connected with each other? What connects two plant cells with each other? What is the connection path? Anyone?
Ma'am, the process of
Yes, someone of you told me the correct answer, that is plasmodesmata. So what is plasmodesmata?
मैम द प्रोसेस फ्रॉम विच टू सेल्स कैन इंटरकनेक्टेड एंड कैन ट्रांसमिट टू ईच अदर
बेटा इट इज नॉट एट ऑल अ प्रोसेस इट इज अ स्ट्रक्चर सो बेसिकली इफ यू कैन लुक इनटू द सेल वॉल ऑफ प्लांट सेल्स एट यू कैन सी स्मॉल गैप्स इन बिटवीन These are the gaps through which cytoplasm of one cell is in connection with others. Okay, and these gaps are known as plasmids. It's not a process. It's not a process. It is the structure. It is also known as cell path. Plasmodesmata is also known as cell path. Okay. Another important thing I would like to mention here, in case of plant cell, though it is very easily we can understand as cell wall is there. There is cementing material which is actually connecting the two plant cells. Can you tell me how in case of animal cells, two cells are getting adhered with each other? वो एक दूसरे से चिपक के रहते, why they don't get separated from each other? What type of structure present in animal cell membrane help them to stick together? Class? Any idea?
Ma'am, microfilaments?
Not microfilaments.
Microtubules.
Yes, one by one. Who said the other answer?
Ma'am, me, Yashvi.
I didn't get you, Yashvi. Can you please repeat, beta?
Ma'am, matrix or some jelly-like structure?
No. They are junctions. These are called gap junctions and tight junctions. And these are the junctions which act as a clamp. क्लैंप देखा होगा आपने जैसे कि एक पिन होता है पेपर क्लिप होती है जो दो तीन पेपर्स को साथ में पकड़ के रखता है केमिस्ट्री लैब में आपने क्लैंप देखा होगा ब्यूरेट या ब्यूरेट को स्टैंड से क्लैंप से पकड़ के रखते हैं सो दे वर्क एज अ क्लैंप सो दिस क्लैंप इज अ क्लिप लाइक स्ट्रक्चर विच एक्चुअली कनेक्ट द टू सेल्स वी विल टॉक अबाउट देम in cell membrane but just for a comparison I told you that in case of plant cell it is the plasmodesmata which is acting as a cementing material to hold two cells together see I am talking about holding two cells together that is done by middle lamella sorry I mentioned plasmodesmata and if you are talking about connection between two cells that is made due to the gap is called plasmodesmata. Understood? Clear? Everyone? Class? You want to repeat me any part?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So,
ma'am?
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, can you please again repeat about that middle lamella and plasmodesmata?
Middle lamella act as a cementing material, which is holding cells together. देखो आप जब plants को देखते हो, plants are made up of what? Crores of cells. But when wind blows or if you touch a plant, it doesn't occur that some of the cells will stick to your hand. They will get detached from the rest of the cells. Isn't it? It doesn't occur. Cells are quite tightly attached with each other. In case of plant cell, it is done by the cementing material called middle lamella. In animal cell, as cell wall is absent, there are clamp-like structures called tight junctions and gap junctions. They are holding cells together. Okay? Now let's talk about the cell connection. How cells will pass on message with each other, how they can be connected with each other. Because consider a situation you know that plants absorb water from root. How will water move? if cells doesn't have any connection between them, some part can be moved by means of cytoplasmic absorption, but rather to say cell wall absorption and imbibition. But how rest of the water will move if you don't have any cytoplasmic connection between those cells? So that is done by plasmodesmata, which is not a process. It is a part of cell, which is like a specific gap. This gap is existing between two adjacent plant cells, and through these gaps present in the cell wall, the cytoplasm of one cell is in connection with the cytoplasm of others. Clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay?
Yes.
Chalo. So we will now look into the cell membrane. Cell membrane is having other names also. It is also known as plasma membrane or even as plasma lemma. Okay, so it's always wise to remember all the names. Consider karo kisi ne plasma lemma puch liya. Even if you know everything about cell membrane, you cannot identify this synonym of cell membrane, you will not be able to understand. So, on the contrary to the cell wall, plasma membrane is a semi-permeable membrane which is living. Why living? Because it's having dynamics, and it can decide what to go inside and what should come outside. So that's why it is very thin. It is comparatively elastic in nature. It's not at all rigid and hard like cell wall. If you look into the look under it for it under microscope, you can see it is transparent. Okay, now plasma membrane is an integral part. It is present in all types of cells. Even if in prokaryotes, even if the composition is different, it is present in all types of cell except mycoplasma. Yes, Rutu.
I'm here. It was mentioned that cell membrane was regeneratable. So, ma'am, is cell wall also, does we can regenerate it?
Generally, the mechanism of regeneration is related to living part. That's why this word is used here, regeneration. Cell wall is a dead part, which is formed. जैसे कि समझो आपकी घर पे दीवार पे अगर एक छेद हो गया, do you say that कि मेरा wall regenerate हो गया? What terminology you use for wall? कि wall repair.
Not bare.
So that's why this regeneration. Obviously, cell wall can also be repaired. How? By deposition of substances over there. But then we do not call it this as regeneration. We call it as repair.
Okay.
Understood? So all types of cell have cell membrane. Maybe the composition may vary a bit, but it feels a compulsory structure. Only mycoplasma, that is a type of prokaryotes, we will talk about it in classification chapter. It is absent, but other than that, it is all present everywhere. So first time the cell membrane structure was studied with the RBC cell membrane, and mainly the human RBC was considered as a sample for study of the cell membrane. So generally the composition and everything we study is of RBC. Major part is same for all types of cell, only minute variation is there. So cell membrane is composed of lipid and protein. In case of cell membrane, I wish to talk a bit more about whatever mentioned in the notes. See, development of cell membrane structure is a long process. Many people tried and worked on it. There was one scientist named Robertson. I wish to mention about him. He proposed a structure which is called as unit membrane. Model. Then there was Daniel Dasher, but Robertson's I must mention here. He said that it is in cell membrane is a structure which is called protein, lipid, and protein. But he considered plasma membrane or cell membrane as a solid structure. The arrangement of these substances is true. इसमें कोई गड़बड़ नहीं है. The one proposed by Robertson, and he said that even if the cell membrane is having similar composition, the similar composition is observed in case of endoplasmic reticular membrane and even the membrane of inner organelle. Only with slight modification, most of them are having similar composition of protein and lipid. But the part why the discovery of Singer and Nicholson, which is known as Lewis mosaic model, is so important, I must mention here about one interesting experiment. They observed कि आप अगर एक radioactive tagged element को या किसी atom या molecule को if you put it in cell membrane, that part is not stagnant at that position. एक example देती हूँ. कंसिडर करो आपके घर पे फ्लोर है एंड आपने उसके ऊपर मार्कर से एक निशान बनाया है. क्या वो निशान इधर उधर कहीं जाने वाला है बेटा? विल इट चेंज इट्स पोजीशन ऑफ इट्स ओन?
नो,
इट विल बी देयर, है ना. बट इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वन, what I can say, the liquid structure, आप सोच के देखो, आप अगर एक पानी के टब के अंदर एक छोटी सी बॉल को रख दो जो तैर सकता है, will that ball be present at a specific location?
No.
It will move. So similar way they observe that the radioactively tagged point is moving throughout the surface of cell. From that they got an idea that cell wall is not a solid structure, it is a liquid structure, and that's why they named the model as the fluid mosaic model. Now if we talk about fluid mosaic model, why we called it fluid mosaic? Have you ever seen mosaic structure? Kabhi dekha hai aapne? आजकल तो बहुत मुश्किल है मिलना. सभी जगह पे या तो टाइल्स लगाई जाती है या फिर पुट मार्बल्स. मोज़ेक स्ट्रक्चर क्या होता है, डू यू नो? एनीवन, एनी आइडिया? इन आवर चाइल्डहुड इट वाज वेरी कॉमन टू हैव मोज़ेक स्ट्रक्चर. आई विल शो यू इमेज, वेट फॉर वन मिनट. यू मे बी एबल टू रिमेम्बर, पुराने जमाने के घर में होता भी था. It's basically cement with colored stones present in it. It looks beautiful. But the problem with them is their life is not that high. Generally, they get rough very easily. That's why nowadays they are not used. So I want you to see the mosaic structure. Why? Because you will have idea about why it is called fluid mosaic.
Ma'am, because the lipid bilayer, it can flow in its place, or it can do the movement.
This is a mosaic pattern. Can you see? Different colors are fused on surface.
Yes,
ma'am. Event. This is how mosaic works. Nowadays we use tiles, but mosaic floor, if you can see, they are used to be like this. ये देखो ऐसे होते थे, और अदर टू से ऐसे होते थे.
So
actually these are arranged or small chips of stones are attached to the cement pool. Now why fluid mosaic? In normal mosaic structure, the main base cement that solidifies. But in this case, the mosaic structure, it is mosaic structure. Why? Because the mosaic ke jo stone chips hote hai, they are compared with the proteins. And the cement part is compared with the lipid. That's why we call it fluid mosaic structure. जैसे कि आपने देखा है इन सेल वॉल इट इज कॉल्ड फ्लूइड मोजाइक स्ट्रक्चर बिकॉज ऑफ दिस रीजन अंडरस्टूड व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड फ्लूइड मोजाइक स्ट्रक्चर इसको और एक तरीके से हम एक्सप्लेन कर सकते हैं वी कैन कंपेयर द लिपिड विद अ सी एंड प्रोटीन्स एज द आइसबर्ग्स फ्लोटिंग ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ सी दो जैसे आइसबर्ग उसमें फ्लोट्स करते रहते हैं Same way proteins can be floating on the surface of liquid lipid. Some of them, जैसे iceberg का थोड़ा हिस्सा अंदर रहता है, proteins can also be like this. Is it clear to all of you? Fluid mosaic structure.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So
now let's have a look into the what is about lipid and protein. Lipid molecules present there are amphipathic. So what is this? Let us understand this word. What do we mean by this specific word called amphipathic? The meaning of this word amphi means both and pathic means it is having feelings. इसलिए बोलते हैं ना सेम पैथी सेम फीलिंग एम्फीपैथी बोथ फीलिंग हाउ बोथ फीलिंग
मैम
यस बेटा
मैम ये एम्फीपैथिक को हम बोल सकते हैं दोज हु हैविंग हेड और टेल
हां दैट टू वी कैन टेल बट दैट इज अबाउट स्ट्रक्चर एम्फीपैथिक इज डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ दैट प्रॉपर्टी बेटा सो व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय एम्फीपैथिक एम्फीपैथिक मींस It has both hydrophobic as well as
hydrophilic
part. Okay, it has both hydrophobic as well as hydrophilic part. Hydrophobic, phobia means dar. So that part is scared of water so hydrophobic and hydrophilic means it is actually loving water so what happens is you must have observed if you take one spoonful of oil and put it into water you will see that water never be able to dissolve the lipid molecules okay so isi tarike se क्या होता है व्हाट हैपेंस एक्चुअली इज व्हाई इट इज नॉट एबल बिकॉज लिपिड मॉलिक्यूल्स आर हैविंग स्ट्रक्चर लाइक दिस व्हाई दिस स्ट्रक्चर ये तो हम अपने सुविधा के लिए ड्रॉ करते हैं बट लेट मी टेल यू जनरली लिपिड मॉलिक्यूल्स हैव अ हेड हेड इज लाइक हेड इज हैविंग द COOH बिकॉज Lipid molecules are made up of generally fatty acid and glycerol. There are other types of lipids also. We will talk about them when we will learn about biomolecules. But generally, the lipids present in cell membrane is having fatty acids and glycerol. So, ये जो fatty acid है, this fatty acid is having a COH at the end and a long hydrocarbon chain. अब तो आपने chemistry में hydrocarbon पढ़ लिया या फिर grade 10 में पढ़ा होगा hydrocarbon क्या होता है?
Yes, ma'am.
एक carbon chain रहता है ना? सो ये जो सी ओ ओ एच रहता है दिस पार्ट इज एक्चुअली हाइड्रोफिलिक और ये जो हाइड्रोकार्बन वाला हिस्सा रहता है लॉन्ग चेन विच इज मेड अप ऑफ सी एच टू सी एच टू सी एच टू सी एच टू सी एच थ्री सी एच टू वट एवर इट इज इट मे बी सैचुरेटेड इट मे बी अनसैचुरेटेड दिस पार्ट इज एक्चुअली हाइड्रोफोबिक सो वट हैपन्स As soon as these lipid molecules are dissolved in or dropped into the water, this hydrophilic head and hydrophobic tail is arranging itself in the form of a micelle. You must have studied about the micellar structure. I know last year this was deleted in CBSE board. Formation of soap and how like soap is cleansing action of soap.
Yes,
ma'am. That's why I am mentioning it here. That ye jo hydrophobic and hydrophilic parts hai, they arrange themselves in the form of a spherical structure which is called as micelle. If you put them into water, they will be arranging themselves like this. What is the benefit? This is the way the hydrophobic tails are away from water because I am drawing it roughly. Actually, these parts are like there is no gap through which water can enter to the micelle. And they will always remain undissolved into the water. So, आप जब फैट में फैट को पानी में डालते हो या ऑयल को पानी में डालते हो यू कैन सी ड्रॉपलेट्स दीज आर नथिंग बट माइसेलर स्ट्रक्चर्स इफ यू शेक देम दीज माइसेल्स विल हैव सम काइंड ऑफ मैकेनिकल इफेक्ट और वो छोटे छोटे ड्रॉपलेट्स में ब्रेक डाउन हो जाएंगे आप ट्राई करके देखना है छोटे से बॉटल में थोड़ी सी तेल और पानी मिला के देखना एंड देन यू शेक देम These big micelle will be broken down into small, small micelle. And if you keep it for some time, again these small micelle will gather together and form a big micelle. Understood this concept?
Yes, ma'am.
So that is yes, why ma'am. The lipids are arranged in the form of a bilayer. Now, why I told you so many things? Because lipids are required to be arranged in a bilayer. आप मुझे बता सकते हो कि क्यों ऐसा होता है कि lipids are arranged in a bilayer? इसको bilayer यानी दो layer में क्यों रहना है? Outside, if you can see in this structure, this generalized view of plasma membrane, you can see that lipid molecules are having hydrophilic head outside. As well as hydrophilic head inside. Why it is required, beta? Why we need to have a bilayer? Agar single layer hota, kya problem tha? Why they need to be arranged in a bilayer?
मैम
यस ऋतु
मैम
मैम सो दैट द हाइड्रोफोबिक टेल्स आर नॉट इन द डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट विद द मटेरियल इनसाइड दैट इज साइटोप्लाज्म
हाइड्रोफोबिक है उसको साइटोप्लाज्म से क्या प्रॉब्लम
मैम इट माइट कंसिस्ट ऑफ वाटर
Because cells have water inside as well as cells have water outside, isn't it? Dono taraf water hota hai na cell mein. Aapke cell mein water nahi hai. 60-70% and even more than that in some cases we have water. So that's why the hydrophobic parts may be required to be protected from both the sides. That's why the hydrophobic parts are present inside, and then the hydrophilic parts are present at the outside as well as inside like this, and hydrophilic parts are like arranged like this, and hydrophobic parts are always remaining inside. Understood, everyone? Yes, Ritu.
Ma'am, what are this phosphatidyl line coline?
Phosphatidyl coline. These are a special type of fat complexes. Okay. They are special type of fatty complexes which are part of cell membrane, and it is cell membrane of I told you the first one that we studied was of RBC. That's right. Yes, Vicky, you want to say something, Peta?
Ma'am, what are phosphothalapide?
Phosphatidyl thalidomide. These are different types of fatty substances. Sphingomyelin is a type of fat. Phosphatidyl serine is a type of fat. Phosphatidyl inositol. These are different types of fatty substances. अब तक आपको बहुत सिंपली पढ़ाया गया है फैटी एसिड, बट दीज आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फैट दैट मे बी पॉसिबली प्रेजेंट इन द सेल मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ एनिमल. ओके, सो ऑल ऑफ देम यू कैन सी द मेजर पार्ट इज मेड हैविंग फॉस्फो. दैट्स व्हाई आउट ऑफ द प्रोटीन्स प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द लिपिड्स प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द सेल, 25 to 32% are cholesterol. Let's all of them are phosphoglycerides or phospholipids. Okay, and phosphatidylcholines are present outside the cell membrane. That means they are attached with the phospholipids present in the cell membrane. So, in case of animal cell, cholesterol is another lipid which is present a lot. That is 32%. So I must say one interesting fact over here. Many a times it is observed ki log dieting karte hain, and when they go for dieting, they actually eat food which is which doesn't have oil at all. Actually, it is not good for them. Leaving a food, obviously for some extent it is all right. If a person is very fat and if that person is going on for dieting, obviously to some extent the body fats present inside the body will be utilized by the body, and they can be used up to a certain extent. But body fats are also required. As you can see, the major constituent of plasma membrane is fat. So a diet which is completely without fat is not at all prescribed. It cannot be a balanced diet. Obviously, less amount we require, but we require oil. Without oil, it's not healthy. They can help you to lose weight quickly, but they have a bad effect on your health. Anything else? Anyone from lipid part of the cell membrane, beta?
No, ma'am.
So we will now talk about the proteins. As I told you, proteins are actually inherent parts which are present or which are attached to this hydrophobic part of the cell membrane. Now, depending upon extraction, when you try and remove proteins from cell membrane, they can be classified into different types. In case of RBC, 52% is protein and 40% is lipid. But this ratio is not fixed for all types of cell. It may vary from cell to cell. But proteins can be of three types. One can be integral protein, that is called intrinsic protein. Another can be stocked as a
peripheral
protein. So who is going to tell me what is intrinsic and peripheral protein? Yes, Vicky, you wish to say something? Bolo, Vicky. You raised your hand first. Okay, Vicky doesn't want to say. Yashvi, will you speak about what are they, intrinsic and
yes,
what are
peripheral proteins are on the outside surface of the cell, and integral proteins are totally buried in the cell membrane.
So, Parv, do you agree with whatever Yashvi say?
Yes, ma'am.
So that's why
I'm peripheral are at the boundary.
Which one will be easy to remove?
Peripheral.
Peripheral. That's why peripheral proteins are known as extrinsic protein and integral proteins are intrinsic protein. There may be some proteins which like can be deep rooted and so much deep rooted that they can be called transmembrane protein, which pass across the length of cell membrane. Matlab samjho, agar if like cell membrane is like this, this protein is present at outside, it passes through the whole length of cell membrane and it is having opening towards the inner side also. Such membranes are also can called as intrinsic protein. And if any protein is like this, it is also intrinsic. If it is like this, then only we call them extrinsic. Apart from proteins, there may be various types of carbohydrates also present, obviously in small amount, but they are present in the cell membrane. They are majorly glycolipids. Glycolipids means carbohydrate plus lipid form a complex, or glycoprotein, that is glycoprotein and carbohydrates form a complex. Okay, now I wish to talk about the classification of protein depending on their function. Are you aware of the classification of proteins depending on the function? How can we classify proteins depending on the function? Yes, Parv, you want to say something? If not, then let's dissolve our today's lecture over here. We will talk next day. We will continue our discussion with the plasma membrane. And we will know what are the different types of protein depending on the function of protein. Depending on their position in the cell membrane, we call them extrinsic and intrinsic. Depending on function, how can we classify them? And we will learn about the fluid mosaic model indeed, that what it is exactly, how it looks like, what are the inherent properties of fluid mosaic model. Any question from your end, anyone, any general question you want to ask me?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Sure.
Ma'am?
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, ma'am, is it that the lipid layer which ma'am, it has two tails?
Two tails means I didn't get what you say, beta.
Ma'am, the lipid structure which we studied today in plasma membrane, does one structure of lipid has two tails?
Very rarely, generally not, because lipid structure means fatty acids. Fatty acids with two big hydrocarbon chain is very rare.
Okay. Okay, ma'am.
So I am ending the lecture today. We will discuss further. I hope you are understanding everything and you are enjoying the class. If any point of concern is there, please let me know. Okay? It's an advantage that someone of you like really studied this chapter already. So you can add up the extra part, and whatever notes you prepared, you can add up the extra points also there in that notes, so that it can be enriched. Okay,
ma'am.
Yes, Yashvi.
मैम प्रोटोप्लास्ट और प्रोटोप्लाज्म आप एक बार फिर से एक्सप्लेन करो ना.
कौन सा बेटा?
प्रोटोप्लास्ट एंड प्रोटोप्लाज्म.
प्रोटोप्लास्ट मींस इट विल हैव सेल मेम्ब्रेन एज वेल एज द प्रोटोप्लाज्म. प्रोटोप्लाज्म मींस एनीथिंग अदर इनसाइड सेल मेम्ब्रेन इज प्रोटोप्लाज्म. सो इट इंक्लूड्स साइटोप्लाज्म, ऑर्गेनेल, एर्गेस्टिक सब्सटेंस, साइटोस्केलेटन, न्यूक्लियस, व्हाटएवर प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द सेल मेम्ब्रेन इज कॉल्ड प्रोटोप्लाज्म.
ओके मैम.
ओके. So I am ending this meeting. We will meet next week and we will discuss. Okay, bye. Bye to all of you.
Bye ma'am. Thank you.
Have a nice weekend, all of you.